It seems like New Year's Eve will be quieter once again as the pandemic spoils celebrations for the second straight year. This report has more.
New Year's Eve might look a lot like last year, with COVID-19 stifling celebrations around the world. Global coronavirus infections hit a record high over the past 7-day period, according to Reuters data, with almost 1 million cases detected on average each day between December 23rd and 29th. In an attempt to slow the rapid spread of the Omicron variant, traditional concerts and fireworks displays that typically draw thousands of people were canceled in most major cities, including London, Paris, and Rome. For the second year in a row, New Year's Eve in New York's Times Square, an event that usually attracts some 60,000 people,
Happy New Year!
Will be a scaled-back event for 15,000 people. Although studies have suggested Omicron is less deadly than some previous variants, many health officials are urging caution, especially among the unvaccinated. In Paris, local authorities mandated mask wearing on the streets starting Friday, and residents were divided over the necessity of doing so.
Do we have a choice? We are not given a choice. Personally, I don't like wearing the mask, but I don't know many people who do, frankly.
In the U.S., health experts warned Americans that a rising tide of COVID cases threatens major disruptions to their lives, from schools to shopping, and urged them to prepare now for a challenging month ahead. Long lines for testing has become commonplace in many major U.S. cities, like at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway this week. For the second day in a row, the U.S. had a record number of new cases based on the 7-day average, a Reuters tally showed, and COVID-19 hospitalizations rose 27%, driven by Americans not yet vaccinated. Some 820,000 people have died in the U.S. from COVID since early 2020.
The U.S. dealing with a surge of COVID-19 infections among children triggered by the Omicron variant. And as this report tells us, hospitalizations among minors are hitting record numbers.
In just a few weeks, the Omicron variant has had an outsized impact on the youngest Americans. The average number of daily hospitalizations for children in the U.S. has soared nearly 60% in the final days of December, compared to about 19% for all age groups, raising concerns about how those under 18 and unvaccinated will fare in the new surge. Dr. James Schneider is chief of pediatric critical care at New York's Cohen Children's Medical Center.
We're seeing record numbers of admissions of all children of all ages, from newborns all the way through 21 years of age, in hospitals and in ICUs with Omicron. Not to say that it's more severe, but it's my experience so far is that it's not less severe, at least in kids. It's just that it's much more contagious.
Even in New York City, which has some of the highest vaccination rates in the U.S., only around 40% of 5 to 17-year-olds are fully vaccinated, compared with more than 80% of adults, city health data shows. There is no authorized vaccine for U.S. children under the age of 5. But the New York Times on Thursday reported that the U.S. Food and Drug Administration is planning to make Pfizer's booster shot available to 12 to 15-year-olds and to those aged 5 to 11 with immune deficiencies. New York City's public schools are set to reopen January 3rd after a holiday break, but the city's health commissioner on Thursday said a decision on a school vaccine mandate is months away.
The city will set a deadline of this spring for a decision about a vaccine mandate in schools to commence later in 2022.
Other parts of the country are also seeing a spike in hospitalizations among children. Ohio has seen a 125% increase among children under 18 in the past 4 weeks, according to the Ohio Hospital Association, while the 7-day average in Florida, New Jersey, and Illinois has at least doubled over the past week, CDC data shows. Fewer than 15% of U.S. children aged 5 to 11 have been fully vaccinated since Pfizer's shot was authorized for that age group in late October.
Russia overtakes Brazil for the world's second highest death toll from the COVID-19 pandemic, behind the United States. Russia's overall pandemic deaths have climbed to nearly 659,000, surpassing Brazil's 618,800 deaths. Only the death toll in the U.S. is higher at 825,600, but its population is more than twice as big as Russia's. So far, Russia's death toll has not been affected by the Omicron variant. and was mostly caused by a surge of infections in October and November, which health authorities blamed on the Delta variant and a slow vaccination campaign. More than 87,000 people died from coronavirus-related causes in November, making it the deadliest month in Russia since the start of the pandemic.